So Neptune is a normal American lobster in every other way, other than his shell. On the inside, he's the same, his body parts are the same, but he has a really rare genetic anomaly where he overproduces a protein complex called crustacyanin, and that causes his shell to be dominantly blue. A true blue lobster like Neptune is only about 1 in every 2 million lobsters. And it's even more rare that they grow to adulthood and are caught. Research says that it's only about 1 in 200 million chance of catching a blue lobster. I think this is because when they're juveniles, as you can imagine, it's harder to camouflage and stay safe when you are in the reddish, brownish, greenish rocks if you're this electric blue. A lobster fisherman who works out of Salem, Massachusetts, Brad Mislinski, he's the captain of the Sophia and Emma lobster boat. He pulled up Neptune in his traps in July, and he knew what a special find this was, and often lobster fishermen will donate really special colored lobsters, really rare lobsters, to schools or aquariums so people can learn from them and observe them. Brad, the lobster fisherman, contacted a teacher that I've worked with for years. Dave Winchester also helps me run these aquaria tanks and knows a lot about lobster care. He said, hey, I think I have something really special for you. And he sent me a photo, and it took my breath away seeing this bright blue lobster. So I was really, really excited. I didn't tell any of the team or my students that week. I didn't want to jinx it because we needed to make sure that Neptune was healthy and, you know, could be brought safely to us. We needed to make sure we had a good space for him. We take animal care really seriously here, so we wanted to make sure we had the space for him. And when that all got arranged, I brought Dave and the lobster up here to the tanks, and I brought all the students who were with us, the high schoolers, up here and said, okay, so we were talking about lobsters, we were looking at some of the tanks on the site already, but now I have a really special visitor for you. So they got to be the first ones to see the unboxing or opening of the cooler, travel cooler of Neptune. It was really, really cool for them. Seeing a really special animal like this always brings out a lot of interesting and different questions. And one of the fun parts of my job is bringing K through 12 students and visitors through here and hearing the questions that they have about these animals. And that often lets me kind of make connections to the research that we're doing here at the Marine Science Center. So any questions that I have or that the students have, I can bring to our awesome research teams and follow up. But we've gotten some really cool questions. One, a question about reproduction. So if Neptune were to have baby lobsters, would those also be blue? And I don't know if we know 100% the answer to that, but our guess was that yes, it's a genetic trait because it's a genetic anomaly that he has, maybe recessive, but it's possible that he could have baby blue lobsters as well. One question that someone asked me about the lobster was, what would he look like when you cooked him? which we won't say that question too loudly in front of Neptune. But you know, people are curious, right? They're used to seeing these animals in the grocery store or on a plate in a pub. And my understanding is that crustacyanin, the protein that makes him blue, would kind of leave and not present as much if he got boiled. So if you boiled him, he would turn out red. And he would look the same, taste the same, but you know, we're not gonna try that out. He's gonna live out his days in retirement here, getting fed his favorite food, having a lovely, clean, spacious tank, and having folks get to look at him.